Neotia wears a hat with many well-adorned feathers. Her endeavours, be it in healthcare, culture or art, have been driven by her commitment to make the world a better place. If you've ever been to the India Story events, you know that the brilliant showcase aspires to shed light on the masterful artistry and design that originate in Eastern India. Madhu Neotia is our Devi for her amazing work as a cultural entrepreneur.
Congratulations on winning the Devi Awards.
Thank you so much.
What do you think of the entire Devi Awards?
I think it's a wonderful idea to give recognition to the women who are working in different aspects, innovative innovative ideas, and so I think to recognize them, because sometimes they get very well hidden, and I think the kind of nominees and the kind of winners you've have had today was wonderful to see that so many people that I didn't even know that they're doing such wonderful deserving work, and that they've got the recognition today.
How do you feel after winning it?
I'm very overwhelmed. Especially I'm overwhelmed even more so because the award was given by Smriti Irani, for whom I've admired tremendously as a woman, because from where to where she has risen, and her belief and her strength and her she inspires all the women who are out there trying to I think in a way trying to establish their work, their dedication, their and as she said, she started from nothing, from nothing and where she's come. So it's always a battle for a woman to, from step to step, how she can reach wherever she wants to. And I think at the same time, she's balanced her life so beautifully, because it's not that she's only in politics, but she's also balancing her home so beautifully. So I think it's a great take back home that a woman does not have to be in the so-called man's world, and she cannot, and that she loses her femininity. So I think it's very important for the woman to have both femininity. It's a privilege for a woman to have a femininity, and also at the same time that she has the strength to carry her dreams, follow her dreams, and to fulfill them.
India Story has done superbly well all through the years, and people are getting to know about it all across the country. So do you have plans of taking it elsewhere, to other parts of the country, down south?
So this question has been asked many times. In fact, when we started the first year, the people said we wanted to, some people from New York invited us, then somebody invited us from England, then somebody said we do in Bombay, somebody do in Delhi. But I felt this is the fifth year, and I felt that I think it was so important to give something to Calcutta, because Delhi, Bombay is all the time something or the other is happening, and other cities have their own properties. Jaipur will have a literary festival, so everybody's identified with something or the other. And I felt that Calcutta is rich in culture. It is the mother of all in culture and art and design, and I felt it's only befitting that Calcutta should be the center of the India Story. And having said that, yes, I'm open to maybe next year maybe exploring another city in India, and we're working on it.